here we are. Here we go.
Jones. We got a comment.
Already getting comments.
Brandon.
What's up? All right. Welcome to another live episode of Red Hill Racing Podcast. This could be epic. This could be
a disaster.
Could be weak. Who knows? We'll see. Just to clarify, we want to and are going to talk about the Spencer versus RG. Now, that all stirred up, obviously, today. Of course, we had it brewing in the background pretty good beforehand. Spencer's going to join us here in a little bit.
I just noticed Ricky's video, and I watched it today, and that's kind of what started it all, right? Because
well, we were already on the back end, though,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, but I mean, it was, but the video really sparked it. His YouTube right. video of him retiring, but it actually just about featuring him race coming up or whatever.
So basically Spencer, you know, he started the fire with some matches, you know, saying he had a poor Ricky tune up he was working on. And Ricky just threw some gasoline on that bitch today.
Yeah. And then all we got to do is just.
That's ding, right. Ding, that's ding. Right. All right. Before we forget, by the way, big giveaway tonight. We're not going to leave y'all out. Somebody is going to win their choice of Kevin Manchester, Manchester Mines Frame Short Neck Service.
Or tonight.
Tonight, yep. Or on top of the excitement, or BMF Motorsports, Mike Burkhart, Carbon Fiber Tank Shell. So we will do that at some point. That's a big thank you to y'all, the subscribers, the Patron members, drinkers. We appreciate y'all. Shout
Quantity
out to
five.
Our sponsors. Yeah. Quantity five, sub up.
You ain't subbed and you're listening, shame on you. Shame on you.
Yeah, for sure. Because we're not even getting ice cream money off.
Yeah. My kid likes cookies and cream ice cream.
Don't make me snort and be blowing my nose and everybody's gonna see it.
Don't make me have a heart attack.
All right, I'm gonna be blowing snot on my computer before this is over. All right. Shout out to sponsors: BMF Motorsports, University of Wind, Energy Coil, Knight Marketing Group, Hard Times Parts and Service, Montgomery Motorsports, Manchester Mines, Schnitz Racing, Platinum General Services, MTC Engineering, Penske Racing Shocks, MPS Racing, and Worldwide Bearings. Appreciate y'all. Dustin knows. Just got off an actual Zoom call with Eric from MTC.
Man, the special guest people is getting the win tomorrow. Like, that is cool. Like, Eric's fired up about having to be in the Zoom call with us. That's gonna be cool.
Selfless promotion plug. That's what we can do. It's our podcast.
Y'all are missing
it's
out,
our podcast. University wins special guest tomorrow night. You have to be a member, but it's a bonus for our members. Eric's gonna be on. He's gonna be talking everything, all things clutches. Yeah. Gonna teach all the members what they need to do, why X equals Y, and hopefully.
Actually, you just said something.
What's that?
It's our podcast.
That's right. Ours. It's our damn podcast.
That's right. If you want to suggest things for us to talk about, do it. If not, we're going to do what we want.
That's the Red Hill Racing.
That's right.
By the way, redneck and hillbilly.
Yeah.
And we race. And sometimes we talk about chickens, and sometimes we talk about racing. So it is what it is. All right. Dustin, another championship from last weekend.
Yeah,
that was. you want to talk about that?
That was a little different,
that was cool.
Man.
That was cool.
So Dustin hasn't entered points at any local track in 10 plus years. I haven't. The last time I won a championship at a local track was at Cherokee, and I don't remember what year it was. And it was just me, my dad, and two other people. You know, and I don't count those on my 40. You know, I've got 9 local track championship, or no, 7 now. I had 6. Now I have 7. A local track championships, but this one was pretty cool. So I missed, I think, 3 races, and most of the other guys missed 1 because they went to SDBA. And real quick, I guess I'll just go over it. We had 2 races in 1 day, and it was crazy because the first race, my points bike got beat like 3rd round, I think. And then Old Faithful, you know, she just goes to semis, and then I about fell over, and then I recouped myself. Everybody was asking me if I was going to race. And I'm like, I looked, pointed outside and Tamara was gassing the box up. I'm like, what do you think? I'm racing. And I jumped
on
them.
Drop over.
Yeah, man. Like I the old boy here went out. Like, I mean, the only thing that saved me was me grabbing a hold of my motorcycle. And like, I went down to my left knees and had my arm on the seat area. And Tamara come running up. Are you okay? I said, just give me a minute. And then everybody come up and I stumbled back in the trailer and took my stuff off. But I just got too hot, I think. And I think actually now that I'm thinking about it, I think my blood pressure dropped because the past 3 days it's been dropping about that time of day the same way. And I think it was due to just not eating and stuff. Anyway, suited up for the second race, and went all the way to the finals against myself. It's pretty cool. My brother come up to me, I think, before the semi, or before the, there was five of us left, and told me I was the champion. I'm like, I have no idea. You know how I am with this stuff. I don't keep track of it.
I don't know, whatever.
I just race, right? And I race to win, and if whatever happens, it falls into place. Just how I do it. I really just love racing with these guys here at home. And they're all getting so good. It's cool to see them get better and everybody become better racers and doing better. And, you know, my brother, of course, has come a long way. He was second in points. Grady Powell, he moved down from Colorado or over from Colorado this year. He's doing great. Marcus Moore is doing better. There's several other ones, Rick Perry. There's a bunch of other ones that race there in points. Pretty tough little crowd there, you know. And, of course, I'm the type of person that likes double entering. And I think most of us do. There's been times we've had right at 30 entries, and there could be five of us that's doubled in that 30.
That's a lot.
Yeah, we have a – it's cool, man. It's an hour from the house, and West Clap bought the – took over the lease or whatever, the racetrack, and he's doing a wonderful job. So I earned myself a straight trip to the World Finals with IHRA. And my dilemma is if I'm going to do that or go to NHRA Division II Bracket Finals, which is the same weekend. I know how you feel about it.
I mean, I just told you my input, but
yeah, your input was why would you go to a Bracket Finals when you can go straight to the World Finals? I'm like, I get it, but I've been begging Red at Bristol. I've been telling Red at Bristol for years, hey, I'm going to come race two races so I can go to bracket finals with y'all. This is the first year that I actually made time to do it. So I feel like I'm obligated to do what I said and finally do that. And
yeah, but I mean, and I love Red and I love Bristol and I love the series he puts on down there for it, but I'm pretty sure I've told him the same thing. And I think I went to one race one time. And I didn't, you know, hey, you paid your dues.
I did pay to run the points and be in the points. And I went and raced and I done well both times I went and, you know, I didn't lose money.
That just means you and I get to try it next year with Uncle Jerry.
Yeah, I mean, I just want to do it. Like, I don't know what I want to do. I'm going to let the weatherman decide.
There you go.
When that race comes up, I'm going to look at the weather and figure it out and go from there. I just think it'd be – I could go to the bracket finals and do good and win there and go to Vegas. Sounds pretty cool versus Mississippi.
That's a good point though. I feel like sometimes we are we don't give enough credit to local tracks and racing, right? Would you agree? Because
so that's something that I've been telling everybody. Like, I try to support these local tracks if I can when I'm home. Like, if I got like a weekend off and I can swing it, sure. Because man, what if one year you're low on money and you can't travel to big races and then you didn't go support your local track and now it's gone or they don't have a class for bikes or whatever.
Well, if it's
just go test there, you got to show some love.
Yeah. And I feel like a lot of times there's maybe like a common misconception that people won't go race like XDA in these larger events. Cause they're like, oh, I'm not good enough. I'm not this. I've seen time slips and tickets, lots of them from Dustin racing at Knoxville. And them boys are killer. Like, that's where that was my racing, point,
bro. Yeah,
like, I feel like sometimes local racing is just as, if not harder, than some of bigger events. So, like, don't be afraid to venture out and go to SDBA, go to Next Day, go to a Man Cup. Venture out because odds are, if you're racing and doing well locally, you can compete. You know, with anybody, just put your mind to it. So,
yeah,
support that. Let's do some shouts. We already shouted out Brandon.
There's a comment, Jimmy, over there that I don't know if I want to address or not.
Artem's on. Montrell, what's up? Oh, appreciate that, man. Well, we try to be bad mofos. The ET gangster, we know he's chilling. I was talking with him earlier.
I was talking to Jeff with Stephen Curie today. I was talking about Jeff.
Yeah. Ricardo, what's up, man?
Yeah.
Oh, Curry.
That's what I was telling you just a little bit ago. I just don't know if I want to comment to that.
Big Curry says, we need Jeremy England coming here and watch his role model.
Yeah. Well, let me just touch base on this real quick. So I'm apparently call, today there were some feelings that got spam. Hurt.
What's yeah, that? Go ahead and touch. I'm going to make sure this isn't
okay. So apparently there was some feelings that I hurt somehow magically with Facebook.
Hello?
Apparently Jeremy, Mr. England, made a post and referred to me in it or whatever. I think over the weekend I'd post a video of my Top Sportsman bike. Y'all know me, right? I'm super proud of how that bike always lives every year. And I wasn't aware that Jeremy's bike puked, you know, or whatever it did. I'm always proud that I can take that motor apart at the end of the year and wipe the pistons off. The bearings look great. So I made a video, you know, like, I don't know if it's the engine builder, the tune-up or maintenance, but it all works. It's always, and that's exactly, I'm just proud of the bike working good. But apparently Jeremy thought I was thinking about him. And y'all, most of y'all know that follow me on Facebook. I've had quite a bit of hell stuff going on lately. I've not been thinking about Jeremy. I will speak on it if I get spoke to about it, like today, a million screenshots and messages, you know, that bullshit. Sorry for the words, but I don't know. He's just got a hard on for me, guys. I'm in his mind all the time. I don't get it. Like, I mean, I have me a government apartment in Ohio, and I live in there rent free, and it smells like cheese, and it's small. That's the end of it. That's all I got for that.
Oh man. So yeah, I think everybody knows you and Jeremy have had your little tits and tats. I've even had it with Jeremy. I'll openly say that. We're currently good. I have no problem. I just do want to say this. Like, ain't nobody wishing people's motorcycles blow up.
No, man, I want nobody's motor to blow up. And I will say this. I heard that he needed a set of rods. I sent a picture to Curie himself and said, hey, I got a set of rods on the shelf. I said, I heard somebody needs some rods. I have them on the shelf. I tell you what. I got a whole 1507 motor in the floor of my garage. Come from Ohio and get it. You're more welcome to come get it and use it. If you blow it up, you pay for it. How about that for the bad guy that I am?
Can't get no better than that. I mean, I don't know. This is a drama episode, man. This is a drama episode.
Yeah, fill it with the drama. That was a little extra something that Steven put in here for us, I guess, didn't he?
Yeah, he said he was starting potties out. He said, peace out. I mean, but I did want to say that. Like, and if Jeremy, if you see this or whatever, man, like, ain't nobody wishing your stuff blows up. That's crazy. Ain't nobody living like that. Trust me. No. Get your stuff together.
I don't want poor old Dave Page have to fix your shit. Dave got enough stuff to do, man.
Dave's trying to eat some zebra cakes, man.
Yeah, man. Retire. Kick back, drink his coffee. Shit.
All right. Enough of that. Yeah. All right. Let's see. What else? Chad's laughing. Tent man, what's happening, brother? Dustin's on. Man, dude, you were so close, Dustin. You were so close. You should have came and visited the garage house here on the farm. But I know y'all had an agenda and had a nice bike trip, Dustin from Penske.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know who you was talking about, Mike. Are you talking to me? So confused.
Sorry. I forgot. This will be recorded. So we're shouting out everybody that's chatting on the live feed now. So sorry, we should have said that up.
Yeah. Also, I did follow Dustin that Penske's little trip, and it was pretty cool, man. You know, riding bikes, tent sleeping. That's awesome. I actually talked to Dustin today. He texted me and checked on me. Appreciate that, homie.
Yeah. I don't know. It's really cool, especially like we said, you know, sometimes there's just too much bullshit on the internet. So it's like, it was cool to see someone that not only works in the industry, you know, is always trying to help out. You know, Penske's a sponsor. Dustin's a big supporter. He's obviously listening right now, him and the whole crew. But he's out there doing it, man. He's a racer, rider, you know, rider.
He's living what he preaches. You know what I mean?
Him and Eric, they put in, 600-700 miles?
And the bikes have Penske shocks that they tuned and set up for the extra weight. It's so cool, man. Like, it was awesome.
Yeah, that was
cool. And Nick Noble asked if he could use the 1507. Well, it's a Gen 2 motor, Nick. Won't quite work for what you need it for there.
What does he need it for?
He said, he just asked if he goes, can I use that 1507? And I was like, you know, it's a Gen 2 motor, so the throttle bodies or nothing works.
Yeah. Yep. Let's see who else we got to shout out. Big Hurry. I think we addressed it.
Brandon Teasley said them brows on fleek been not.
That's right, bro. I keep them on fleek, you know. Yeah. I just need me a nice little nose ring over here on the side.
I got to mow my median every once in a while. I got to take care of the median, groom it like the county does.
Man, we do our third live broadcast, and my boy Brandon's picking on my eyebrows. I do. Hey,
that's bro. I love all the Teasleys, but that's my favorite Teasley right
favorite.
There.
I know Tiffany's probably watching from inside the actual house, away from the garage house.
Mine's downstairs watching, I guarantee it.
Brandon wants to know where his damn wedding invite is. He was very upset last weekend, so I'm just saying. Wow. He was. He didn't want to hear none of my. I was like, I wasn't even really giving an excuse. He was upset. Well,
Brandon, I have a proposal for you, and not the wedding proposal. I have a spot in the JJ arm drop at Knoxville Dragway that I can't go to because I'm going to their wedding. If you want the spot, you can have it if you want to come to Tennessee.
There you go. There
you go.
No
prep.
Let's see. Who else do we miss? Oh, our school member from Down Under. What's up, Luke? Appreciate it. Rob, another school member. We got Evan Stevens. Everybody, we appreciate all the shout-outs.
Crystal Spires, big-time follower.
Yep, Crystal. Multiple giveaway winner. Chris Johnson. Shout out to everybody. Appreciate the support. James, another school member. Corey. Let's see. What did Tiffany say? Brandon, you know you and your wife are my favorites. Oh, there's your invite.
Yep.
Got lost apparently. Oh my goodness. Jeremy England said, "What's
I hope
up?"
He,
man?
I hope he goes back and watches what I said a little bit ago. He might come down here and get him.
There you go, Jeremy. There's an offer on the table. You might have to go back. 1507, ready to go. Come down and get it from
under the bench. Come get it.
We ain't wishing nobody no bad stuff, Jeremy. If you missed it, let's see. Oh, Mr. Mahoney, Mobile Lab Racing, dude. Did we get the approval yet? I need the approval.
Yeah.
For that
shirt.
He
was surgical with that bitch.
We're making t-shirts. All right. Y'all want us to get the Amish guy on? We can do it. He can't be on here. Yeah, he can't be on here. Like, you can't see his pretty face. Well, first off, it's probably break the computer, but he said he was incapable, didn't have a computer for it.
So Ben has to, like, phone hold. It's going to be weird.
Yeah, so we're going to do our best. We're going to put him on speaker. We're going to try it. And Spencer said he texted RG and is trying to get him on, so we'll see what happens.
Push it.
Oh, all right. Well, fair enough. All right. All right, let's call this guy. Bye now. No, we're not done yet. Hold on. Oh, I got to try and do this.
What are you doing?
We're Everybody alive. Wants to know what you're doing.
Oh, right now I'm taking apart a real street bike.
Taking apart a real street bike. All right.
Yeah.
Doing what? You getting ready for this?
Put them
epic
extra
matchup?
Special pistons in there for that old crap button.
Pull the motor out this year since it hasn't been out all year, and you know, finally get it all cleaned up and ready to go. That way, if Ricky wants to bet a little bit more money, we're ready for him. You know,
we did not know. So a little background for those of y'all. I mean, you've probably heard us talk. You know, we got a little DRR group, me, Dustin, Spencer, Joe Deck, Ron Arnold, Spooky, who else am I missing? Randall. We got quite a few people in our
Ricky's
group.
On here. He's
oh,
on there commenting.
Ricky said he's ready. Anyways, we were already talking a little bit in the background, and then Spencer, who's on speakerphone right now, he made a post. He said we love you. You're a boy, but I would say you're like a undercover shit talker, is what I would say.
Yeah,
like, you'll post little bits and pieces, but never like really full fledged in it. And you posted that. Don't make me use it or working on a poor Ricky tune up. And then RG comes back with a full fledged YouTube video. I mean, clickbait. He's going to retire.
Oh, yeah. He's retiring. Come on. We know better.
So
I haven't even watched the video yet. I just saw bits and pieces of it. But
yeah, it's only 5 minutes, bro. I even watched it and I was busy as shit. Hey, Ricky, you hear this? You're what?
I said, I've been busy gapping rings and getting pistons ready.
Cam Ford. So what,
he's gapping rings to gap a Kawasaki.
Gapping rings to gap a cow. There we go. Ricky said he hears you loud and clear. He's commenting on the feed. Let us know if you want to jump in here. I can send you a link if you're at a computer, Ricky. Anyways, yeah. So as far as I know, Potts up to what? It's right now. It's currently 3,500 total, right? So it's 2,000 win Real Street, 500 runner up. Y'all agreed it all goes to the winner. And then we had already got what, another grand on top, so 3,500. Ricky, yeah. What we want to know is where are we trying to get this pot to? Because
I did see that part of the video. That's the only part I really wanted to pay attention to, because whenever he said about, you know, trying to get the pockets all up and doing stuff, well, I mean, I've been practicing that for the last 2 years with a grudge, so I'm ready to get the pockets up, you know.
Where are we at, Ricky? What are you trying to get to? You got an idea number-wise? We talked a little bit beforehand. You know, Dustin and I were stirring it, of course. We'd like to see at least, you know, probably what, five grand, winner take all, one pass. What do you think?
Oh, Ricky, he said, whatever you come up with, we'll cover it. All right. So, sounds good.
Well, Ricky is confident. He's going to go with experience over, you know, I think we still think we're young, but we're getting old too. So.
Yeah, I know, we're all old as shit. Yeah, except Spencer.
All right.
You almost feel bad picking on an old guy, you know.
Oh man,
y'all gonna get my heart rate too high, man.
Y'all gonna cause Dustin to stroke out. Well, Ricky said whatever we come up with, he said they'll cover it. I don't know. I say $5,000. What do y'all say? Can we get a $5,000 pot? That's $2,500 on top of what XDA is going with.
You know, like, look at right now. So I just realized today that Pro Street didn't finish as well as we did.
Right.
So what, you know, like Dunnigan and Williford in the final for the same race, same time. Why aren't they doing anything? Why aren't they betting? I'm kind of let down. Like, they always talk about, you know, Real Street, you know, not really doing a whole lot. Well, Pro Street, what are they doing? They ain't betting nothing. They ain't talking about it. Nothing. I think that ought to be your next podcast.
Man, y'all are trying to stir and click everything
it's
tonight.
The
I love
race
it.
Of the year, might as well send it off. You know.
No, I mean, I agree. You'd think they'd want to race for something. Look, I'll put it like this: that was part of the reason I came back to Real Street, man. Especially with bubble wrap and everybody, you know, it was just shit talking. Oh, Ricky said send him a link. All right, I'm gonna work on it. Yeah, I agree with you, Spencer.
Yeah,
you know, this is hype. This is great. It's good for the sport. It's good.
Well,
for
you
the
remember
class.
Back in our Real Street group, me and Spencer with, and yeah. Cameron and all of us in there just make.
You know, it's the reason why I came back to Real Street. Just missed it.
Sorry, I realized at this point that I just realized you can't really hear Dustin talking.
No, he can't hear me. No.
I don't hear Dustin at all talking.
My bad.
No. I thought he was just being quiet. I didn't know what he was doing.
No, I forgot because you had to call in on a damn phone. Hold on. I'm trying to send this to Ricky. Yeah, what were you saying, Dustin? I'll tell Spencer.
Oh, anyway, so back
in – I'll watch it in the – hold on. I'll turn – Let me step out the shot. Hold on.
Y'all getting ready to mess Spencer way up. He's going to try and listen.
He's going to be echoing Owen.
You know.
Yeah. So anyway, back a few years ago when Ben was in Real Street and even before Ben come back, me and Spencer, I would make funny like pictures or videos after every race, no matter who won or lost. Like there was a time that Scott got on the camera and was like, we've got the new Holley system this year and we're unstoppable. And then Annabelle beat Spencer in the final. So I made a video of Scott saying that and then Annabelle holding up a stop sign, you know. So we had a great time. And I really think it hyped up the class. Like we.
Oh, for sure.
Some of them guys took it pretty rough, though, and run off a couple new racers pretty quick. But we did have fun. And, you know, when Teasley's left us, it got a little calmer.
Now I can hear Spencer listen.
Yeah.
So I just sent RG a link, man. We're making it big time. We're gonna have him on. You know, I have to give him credit though. He's one up in you. You know, Spencer, we're gonna have RG getting ready to tap in, join in with, I'm assuming, an actual camera because he has that capability.
Well, would Spencer's just give him audio if he went on?
Yeah, it don't work.
I don't
work
like that.
trying to watch it on the live feed and then talk at the same time. It's too delayed.
I can give you what Dustin says if it's anything. Ricky has a link. He'd probably be joining us here anytime. I'm excited.
Mike Mullaney is him and Richard Gadsden are Mountain Post Op bodies right now.
When that jitterbug is, he can click on it and be easy to find.
Jitterbug. Hold on a second. I got to type jitterbug. I sent it on Facebook Messenger. Got to let RG know.
No, Richard Diggs, I did not run off Alicia. They did. I didn't. I was trying to motivate her to keep going. She put that on me. Here.
I don't know. I'm trying to see if Ricky jump on here. Let's see here. All right, he's seen it. Oh, he's getting ready to jump on here. So, Spencer, you're not going to be able to hear everything, I don't reckon. Where?
No.
This is going to be a little rough.
Send it to Spencer and see if he does his computer have audio?
Spencer.
Is there any other way to log in or something? Like,
if you have a computer, then yes.
I have a computer, but I don't have a – there's no camera on it.
We don't need a camera. We just need audio.
We can try it with audio.
Well, send me a link.
I already did check your email, fool. It went to that BMX or something, I think.
All right.
Let's see here. Let me.
It's very interesting live podcast.
This is close
guys.
To a disaster. Kinda.
No, this is really what the people love. This is the real thing. Raw stuff here.
Let's see. What kind of. We got, Mike Mullaney, RG5 on here. They're Mountain Pro Stock bodies.
Right. They're working on Pro Stock. Proud sponsor of that ride.
There we go. Oh, snap.
I heard a noise.
No.
There he is.
Oh,
what's
my
up?
Goodness. The retired man himself has joined.
Yeah, man. Look. I started retiring and I thought about it. I said, I still got one more ass to whoop. So I can't retire yet.
Spencer, since you're so Amish and you can't hear this, Ricky said he really thought hard about it, but it just occurred to him he had one more ass whipping to hand out.
Oh, man. It's kind of funny. The video he showed was an old video. The last video that I had was me driving away from him at 1,000 foot.
Oh, yeah. But remember, I gave you that video.
You did record it.
I recorded it, and I sent it to you. To give you something to motivate you.
Yeah. Spencer, so, RG said that you were very right that it was an older video, but he said, where did you get the latest video? He said he was gracious enough to send it to you, but he sent it to you for motivation. So Ricky, it sounds like we're solid at 5K. So 2,500 on top from each party.
I don't see that being a problem. I'll make a couple phone calls, and I got some buddies that wanted to chime in. He's like, man, how can I get in? So I don't think that'll be a problem.
Ricky Spencer said that he doesn't think that would be a problem. He's got some buddies just like you do that have already chimed in his ear. So scraping another 25 hundo around for y'all to race for $5,000. Same purse that Pro Street races for at the last XDA. Man, I think Jason Miller needs to pay us, y'all. We're hyping this event up.
Promoting his race.
Like, what do y'all think?
Well, here's the thing. Like, I think that Real Street, to be honest with you, Real Street
working,
is
working. I don't know.
Hold on, Spencer. You got to let us talk first, and we'll let you know what's going on. Oh, wait. Hold on. Sorry.
Yeah, he's ready to come in there.
Devices. Let me see if I can get him on here. We might kick from ban from studio. Oh, hold on.
Uh-oh.
Can you hear us, Spencer?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I can hang up. Perfect. We're all together. Wow.
All right.
All right, Ricky, you have the floor.
My job here is done.
Hold on. One second real quick, Ricky. Look, it took Ricky to motivate Spencer to get his ass on the computer and figure this out. I done sent him a link an hour ago. Wow.
You know how hard it is for an Amish guy to get on a pooter?
Yeah, man, I'm getting ready to have another side pot. Ricky's starting to gain a little bit of interest in me. So go ahead, Ricky. Tell him what y'all can all hear now. Now we're all on the same page.
That's good. I was saying, I think that, first of all, I think that Real Street should be one of the most exciting classes there is. Because, and I'm really happy lately that our turnout's being is getting bigger and bigger. Because,
for sure,
you know, we are the stepping stone to Pro Street, and most people can't afford to go Pro Street, including myself. And it exactly. is the fastest class, heads up class that there is. Now, the most important part, and the most interesting part about it is that, you know, we got to ride these motorcycles. You can't say in Pro Street, you just find somebody got heart and put them on the bike and put everything on automatic. And that bike's going to go down through there. All they got to do is point it and shoot it.
It got to be a little crazy, though.
Oh, you definitely got to be crazy.
Yeah.
I'm not taking nothing from them guys.
Yeah.
I've been 670s on a Pro Street bike that we bought from Mark.
And, yeah, I remember that.
It got my attention, because the fastest I had been was 680s on a bar bike. That was different than going 680s, 670s, 440s in the eighth mile at 217 mile an hour. That was quite a bit different. So
yeah,
I give those guys no doubt at all. I take my hat off to them guys. Rodney is just absolutely out of his goddamn mind.
Agreed.
But what I'm saying is, it is they can get adjusted to the speed. If they can get adjusted to the speed, you put yourself okay. Here's an example. Aaron put his son on the bike. Aaron Litton, he put his son on his bike. His son had only ridden Real Street. Last year was the first time his son ever even been in the 7 second zone, right. And now Aaron Litton got him going 640s, 650s. So that just kind of goes to show, and I'm not taking nothing from him. That's my boy. And his son is doing his thing. But what I'm saying is, we gotta ride these. Ben, you know, we gotta ride these motorcycles. And you had one of the hardest bikes to ride. You know what I'm saying? Because you didn't have the, you know, that the superchargers is just instant on yeah. or off. You know, so we gotta ride these bikes. We don't have slider clutch, and the all motorbikes do, and they deserve it.
They gotta have it.
Jason has found a way to level out the playing field, which I think right now is awesome.
It is really good.
Like
I feel like it's been pretty
for the past couple good of years.
Parody, probably really the last 3-4 years or so. And I agree with you, Ricky. I mean, like, it hurts me a little bit that like there are Gen 2s and stuff, but I understand why. And I feel like, and this is not to take it away from any of the, because I have high respect for the, you know, the all motor, all of them. I think they're all great riders for sure. And they probably do fine. Like,
I think you ought to ban the MTC and put a hand clutch on everybody and just give them wheel based.
Well, here's what I was going to say, Spencer. Here's my thoughts. It's purely my opinion. Like, y'all know I'm a perfect example. I rode Ralphie's bike twice last year. I won and I runnered up. It was fucking easy for me. But if you gave me a hand clutch, man, I would have screwed that up 8 ways sideways. I think the great riders would still be pretty damn good. Hell, you've seen it. Ryan, JT, they jumped on the bike Trevor's riding now. Like, they rode it hand clutch. If you're a great rider, great. Y'all can do good. But and like I said, don't take this as a knock to any all motor rider now, because they're all great riders for sure. But I'm not. Like, I'm a racer. You know, I pride myself in racing. I'm an average rider. So, no.
All motor guys also have to milk their damn combo.
What kills me about the motor guys, all right, ask any one of them, and they tell you, man, if you gave me 5 inches more wheelbase or whatever, I could still hand clutch this bike, run just as fast. Every one of them will tell you that. I guarantee it. Well, the problem, and then they ask, why you run Gen 2? Well, it's more consistent. That's why we run it. Well, what do you think we have to battle? That's why I don't. Yeah. Real Street's a rider's class. Make it a rider's class.
It's harder to cut a light when you got a hand clutch in your hand, right?
You got to control the bike and try to react.
You got to control. You got to literally, I go wide open when the light drops. I got to go wide open and control the front wheel, right? And react to the light turning green. If I react too fast by letting the clutch go too soon, I got problems, because now the front wheel's in the air. Once the front wheel's in the air, then you got to pedal the throttle. So
especially
you had a good lot, but then it wheelied.
Yeah.
Oh God.
What'd you say?
Cause you'll cut a good light. You sacrifice one or the other.
Yeah.
You either try to kill a light But now the front wheel's in the air because you slam the clutch to get that line. Now the front wheel starts to come in the air. And with bikes like Spencer and mine, once the front wheel starts to come in the air, the nitrous is coming right behind it, or you're already leaving with nitrous and it's progressing. You already got a turbo, and the turbo is on timers, and it's starting to...
You're behind the goal right there. You're done.
Already. So,
sorry, I was looking at some comments. And I think, by the way, they said I was dogging you, Ricky, because I spelled your name wrong. I think he had to put that in. He accidentally typed Rocky instead of Ricky. I didn't do that. I wouldn't dog my man like that. Come on now. I could do some petty shit, but I could name him.
I gotta remember. I probably did that, but remember, I am from Philly.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Rocky's from Philly. Right. Yeah. I'm a huge Rocky fan now. Hold up. I love me some Rocky.
I think Real Street and Superstock, I mean, those are the riding classes for sure. What's so funny? Destiny at the last race, we was in the lanes for something, and she looked at me, she said, why don't you ever run Superstock? I said, shit, I'm a terrible rider. You want to see some shit, that would be me. And she was like, no. So I appreciated her vote of confidence, but no.
I would love to do that stuff, but I'm just too damn fat.
They need a big boy Superstock. I'm telling you, that'd be perfect.
Yeah, that
everybody wants their own class, man.
Like Ricky said, 200 pounding up. Yeah, this is great though, y'all, because I haven't felt like there's been hype like this really since I don't know what, when we were all when we had bubble wrap and all the Teasleys, and we were all going at each other's throat. And I will tell Ricky,
that is the reason why I really escalated that ZX10 and getting it back in Real Street, because y'all was having too much. Y'all was talking shit.
Man.
Dustin was talking shit for Spencer. Like, yo, this shit was hype. And
remember all them funny videos I made, dude? Like, I made so many funny videos. It was crazy.
Cameron Teasley, boy. Missed them in the class. Like,
I do too.
Yeah. Like, I loved when I came in the class and all three of the Teasleys was in there. You know? Like,
oh, my goodness. That was awesome. Man, yeah. Ricky, you're right. I love talking shit. That was my favorite. I mean,
Cameron get carried away sometimes. He'd hurt my feelings, boy.
Ricky, I will say one thing. You know one thing that I'm jealous of, and you ought to know what it is. Got it. Mother effing 40, man. I wanted that son of a bitch so bad. I melted that motor at that last race. I wanted that. When Jason did that, I went from don't get me wrong, like Eric at DOS Performance built me obviously a badass combo and bike. And he gets all the credit for sure. I just happened to do an okay job riding it, right? But I went from like trying to like be smart and race. As soon as Jason made those 40s, first of the 40s, I was like, I will blow my shit up Spencer style if I have to. I don't give a
shit. You did.
Yeah, I melted it down, but I didn't get the 40. Ricky did.
Listen, here's the crazy stuff. When I was putting the bike together and the last race of the year before I brought the bike out, all y'all motherfuckers went 50s. JT went a 52 or something.
Yeah.
His brother went a 51. Like, you went in the 50s. I'm like, yo, this
had a head start.
I was just shooting for 60s.
Yeah. You
know, my bike had only been 90s back in the 90s when I was headed out last, you know?
And you gave us, we rode you hard because you were posting all your content. And I mean, look, hey, that takes a man. I'll give you mad credit there. That takes a man to post a pass where you stall that bitch, especially man. But hey, I mean, I was like,
listen, the bike is, you're going to have teething pains when you bring a bike out, right?
That's right.
And you develop and think about it. The only one out there that could give me help, any kind of help, was Chad Sosnowski. Yeah. Because he had his ZX10 Turbo. But his combination was totally different than mine. You know, he didn't even use a Max ECU or anything. So we really had nobody to go to. So when I was out there stalling it and everything, we're thinking we got one problem and it was something totally different. But we didn't have anybody to go to ask. But still, I felt like since people was interested in the bike and interested in the development of the bike, it was my responsibility to show them the bad along with the good. We didn't have any good to show them. But
you were fully transparent.
I wanted to see the steps it took.
I mean, I watched it. I watched all that stuff.
And I respect you for exactly what you said, but you obviously now know and knew you were throwing all kinds of stuff in the Shark Tank. We were eating you alive.
You ate me alive good when I posted that one where I thought it was good. Where I thought I went 540s or something on my first full pass, full 8th mile pass, and you were laughing. And then I asked a question. And when I asked that question about 260 or something like that in the back half, I didn't see anybody else's ticket. So I really didn't know. I wasn't being smart.
Ben was fired up.
Ben got me all fired up on
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, and Dustin knows. I'm everybody knows, especially the podcast listener. Like, I'm bad at maintenance. It's not my strong point. My shit runs usually for the most part. But when it came to Real Street, that's the most effort I ever put anything. I tested a lot before that season got going in. And I don't want to say like it helped with COVID, because I don't wish any of that. But I'm saying, like, because of COVID, I did get a lot of testing in that otherwise I wouldn't have been. That's how I came out swinging so hard. And I wasn't posting shit. I kept my stuff secret. Hell, I went to Maryland and ripped off the first time I went quarter mile testing. I went 63, mm-hmm. 62 back to back, and not like I didn't tell nobody at first. Like,
no,
Jimmy Miller was there. And he was helping push me. I wouldn't even tell him for like an hour or so.
It was a rumor out that you had went that fast, and I didn't believe it. It was a
rumor. You know who was there, Ricky? Was why'd I just blank? On the used to have the yellow Gixxer, the nitrous one. Sherelle was
Sherelle Blake.
Yeah, Sherelle. Yeah, that's who it was. Sherelle was there, and actually, he pushed me back once. He was like, "That looked like a pretty good pass," and I looked at Thicke, and I was like, "Yeah, it was pretty good." And I was like, "Fuck, I just went 760s on like my first all-out pass." And I was like, "I couldn't even say nothing because like Sherelle been racing for a while in Real Street, and was like, you know, I just felt like I'd been an ass if I even told him at that point. I was like, damn, Spencer, were you still alive over there?
Oh, yeah. I'm just listening to the stories.
You listen. Remember who beat you at the first race with a brand new bike and combo?
Yeah. I heard that some veteran let the rookie have a free pass with a red light. That's what I heard.
Man, I'm y'all are getting me amped up. I'm looking at
Ben's going to be converting it back to Real Street.
Y'all got me amped up.
So, Spencer,
yeah,
I gotta give you credit. You got that thing rolling. You're taking your grudge combinations and you bring it to Real Street. And you got it rolling. But you know what else I know? I know you know how to blow them motherfuckers up.
Oh yeah,
we will too.
And you're going to blow it up trying to catch me. You know it.
No, I wasn't no catching. They're just gonna be trying to make the gap bigger. That's all it's gonna be.
Ricky,
I want to be the first to 200 Friday night. That's my goal.
Is that so when y'all are racing? Do y'all know?
I'm assuming Friday night.
I would assume it would be the first round of qualifying Friday night.
Oh, my gosh.
I think his Real Street motor might be bigger than his grudge motors.
Oh, yeah. Spencer got the biggest. Spencer got a 1900, don't he?
It's close.
I know you ain't supposed to put no nitrous to nothing that big, that's for sure.
I know Spencer can't see it, but Ricky and Dustin can. I just pray that this pass on Friday night is clean for both of y'all. That's all. Because if Spencer chokes,
there's gonna
up
be fireworks.
Loses
to finish
my
line.
Money because he fucks the launch shit up, I'm gonna be mad. And that's me talking shit. I just want a clean pass. If Ricky, you win, that's cool. That's fair. I just want a clean pass. And I know that's what you said earlier, Ricky. That is so hard that people don't understand about this class. You can be ripping off numbers. I don't care if you're RG, Spencer, whoever, Ryan. It doesn't matter. JT, you can still have a minor hiccup and lose 0.05, a tenth, in a single pass.
That's right. Oh, yeah. If every time I have to cut gas, every time I have to cut throttle off the starting line because the front wheel came up, I lose 500s.
Yeah, right? Easy. Yep. Yeah.
And that's what's so, to me, that's what's so wild and exciting that we're pushing this pot up. And I mean, like, you want to talk about a gamble? This is a gamble. Like, if y'all, I'm just hoping that we get two clean passes.
Exactly. I'm hoping two clean passes. Like the last time we raced, remember?
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah. Oh, he remembers. The one
where you ran off and hid on me, because ain't nobody ever did that to me before. Yeah, that hurt me. When I came back, I said, Gary, I said, G, fucking Spencer ran away from me, G. Like, away from me. He said, we having problems, dude. I said, yeah, we are. But still, I ain't never seen nobody do that to me.
With a mullet flying in the air. So, it waves at you. It's like, bye, Ricky.
That will be on my mind when that light drops and I plug second gear, boy. If I'm anywhere near in front of you, Spencer, you got problems. Because you going to hit that button. You going to hit that button.
I've been practicing. I put my thumb over that button, and I just hover it there and wait. But no one's made me push it yet. I've just been waiting. I just hover it there.
Work that finger out.
That's why I'm bringing all these spare motors. Hopefully we race Friday night, so I got time to fix it for Saturday.
Oh, now, man. I tell Jason I want to do it. I want to tell him I'm going to do it on Sunday morning, but that way you be done blew up everything.
Hey, I'm telling you right now, Spencer, you blow that shit up on Friday and lose, I am not helping you with shit. Yeah, long if you win, I will gladly fix whatever. I will be there. I won't even get Darnell. I will be there sober and working on stuff, being helpful. You blow that bitch up and lose to Ricky, I'm going to watch. I'm going to go help Ricky work on
it. Nah, if he blows it up and loses, I'll come bitch at him while he fixes his shit.
Well, y'all know, when y'all come past my pits, we ain't never hardly ever working on the bike.
Oh, hell no.
That's that turbo life, man.
That bitch is just sitting there.
Yeah. I have to get Spencer, me one of them turbo things.
Actually, I'm gonna ask Ricky first. If you win 5K on Friday night, what are you gonna do with it? You gonna spend it on something?
I'm going to Disney.
Disney. Oh, there you go. Oh. I'm gonna tell Spencer what he's doing. He needs a new set of leathers, man. I try to put together that graphic earlier.
Advanced. Duct tape. I hope he's listened.
Duct tape on it. He's what the hell? Look like a ragtag Amish guy for sure.
I just been spending money on pistons. I ain't got all that money for nothing.
Oh man. Let's see. Well, we got some comments. I know Spencer can't see them, but Ricky, can you see any of the comments over there? Let's see.
No, because I got all of us on the screen.
So. Okay. Let's see. Mike Mullaney, he said he's with your nephew right now. He said RG5 said that was the greatest Facebook group ever. You damn right. That Facebook group was lit.
There was 95 so people that weren't even in Real Street in there just to hear it.
Yeah, the Real Street group was like what, 2,000 members?
Oh, it was and there's ridiculous.
Like 50 bikes in the world that run Real Street.
y'all had RG5 ready to hit that class hard. RG5 was going through, I don't know what happened, but he built his bike and I think it was the weekend and he went out there to help JT and he had to change the clutches. He had to pull the clutches out and change them every single run. That really discouraged him.
It was that yellow one, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yep. He had a badass bike.
Yeah. Yeah.
Everybody was in the class at that time, man. Like it was
a good
time. The only one we was missing was Johnny Turbo. That's it.
I was with JT last 2 weeks ago. He said, "Have fun." He ain't coming back.
Yeah, he on that boat, man. He done.
He on that boat every weekend.
Really can't blame him. That's a long drive from Florida up there, man. It really is.
What? I can't believe he did that every time.
I know. Yeah. That's man, crazy.
Sean Henson has been coming up racing with the sun, and man, that's a hell of a drive for sure. Let's see. Fabian said, Chad Sanowski, this is what we wanted to see. I don't know what Chad said. I must miss it. Ed Murphy, Ricky said, you got 100 on you. Artem said, make the pot 10K. I don't know. That's up to them. I don't know. Five sounds reasonable.
Artem, are you going to contribute to that 10K? Are you going to help build that up?
Actually, Artem said earlier that we need a GoFundMe and a lot of people contribute. And I said, the idea is a cool idea, but that in theory, that's not going to work because it'd be a cluster and that'd be illegal too.
I don't think we need to do that anyway, because if Spencer got enough people on his side, Spencer's going to hit me up and be like, hey, I got 6. I'm like, all right, I got 7. You know what I'm saying?
We're already up to 8.
Oh, man. He said, bullshit. Man. 5K Friday night XDA. It's gonna be epic. I'm gonna have to get off here and not right now, but I'm saying I'm gonna have to text Jason and be like, dude, you know, I think you owe us all a free gate entry. We just hyped this up more than anything.
No. We're going to Maryland. He just needed to buy us Foxy Fish. We're good.
There you go.
There we go. All right. Y'all got anything else y'all wanted to talk about?
Yeah, I want to call out the Pro Street guys.
Okay, call them out. So what you saying that
that their class is boring and they need to race for some money. That's what I'm calling them out.
Can I tag Jason Dunnigan in this thing?
Please. Oh, I feel, I forgot about what happened when he left the racer. I feel bad for him now, thinking about that.
Oh, that yeah, was, you are.
That's bad.
Yeah.
Yeah. I ain't tagging Jason. That's fucked
yeah,
up.
Yeah.
We're leaving it alone, but this is hype, man. This is great. Thank you, Ricky, for jumping on last minute. I know we didn't get with you earlier.
We had no idea what we were doing. Look,
Dustin and I, and we know we just so busy with life and work and everything. We have been slacking a little bit, not intentionally, but hey, this is awesome. I seen this morning. I texted Dustin. I was like, we got a topic tonight. We're going to hype this up even more and to get y'all on. And then Ricky done showed Spencer up how to use a computer. It's awesome.
Y'all know Spencer Amish. He ain't even allowed to have electricity. Y'all lucky he got a phone.
Yeah, he gaps his ring with candle lit around the table. Yeah, it's crazy. Ricky, I've been there.
That's probably why his shit blows up all the time. He doesn't actually know how to use a computer. He's just like,
The gap is the width of the candle.
All right, guys. Y'all can hang loose real quick, but we got to do a giveaway for all our listeners. But I'll let y'all go unless y'all got anything else. Me and Dustin will close it up. Thanks, Ricky. Appreciate it.
See you, Ricky.
Thanks for joining us.
Spencer, hey, I got something to say real quick. One time, me and Ricky got stranded on a back road coming from Maryland.
You remember? Oh, I remember you telling me that.
Yes.
You
know,
real quick, they're coming from Buzz Creek. There was a detour. We couldn't get on 95, right?
Yep.
They had something going on. So they had detour signs, right? Well, the detour signs, as we're making these turns,
it was ridiculous.
Crystal was saying, this looks like the movie Wrong Turn.
Yes.
That's a scary ass movie, by the way.
Yeah.
He said, this ain't right. I'm like, yeah, it is. Yeah, it is. The sign just said turn right here.
There's arrows. Yeah. Like we couldn't mess it up.
All of a sudden, it damn near turned into a dirt road, right?
Yes.
And it got so narrow that there was no turning around. I got 70 feet of vehicle. He got like 60 feet of vehicle, right? There was no turning around. All of a sudden, I see a vehicle up in front of me, just the flashing lights of a vehicle up in front of me.
That was me.
The road ended.
They had a bridge blocked off. It was just, that was it.
So I'm behind him. When he walks back, I realize it's Dustin. We the only two dumbasses on this road.
There was three. There was three.
I'm saying, yo, what the fuck are we going to do? We can't turn around. He said, shit, I don't know about you, but can you back up? I said, yeah, back up, but I can't see behind me. Like, it's so dark.
It's black. Yeah.
All of a sudden, we get light, miraculously. It's a tractor trailer. Now
a semi.
Now, and he can't back up. Oh, my God. It took me.
Then I find a little cable I was going to take down, and the cops show up. They wouldn't let me take the cable down so we could back in there and pull out. It was a mess.
Dude, we had to back up for like 4 or 5 miles backwards on the road. I'm using the headlights of the tractor trailer. Dustin's using my headlights so you can see the road to back up, yo.
That's ridiculous.
Thankfully,
my trailer had reverse lights. That helped me so much in that deal.
Oh, and I have floodlights.
You turn your back lights on, yeah.
Yep. I have floodlights on the back of my trailer.
I remember Dustin telling us about that. I was like, that's just the craziest story.
It's like
ever.
I felt like an idiot. Then Ricky pulls up. I'm like, okay, I'm not the only idiot. We're both idiots.
Hey, real quick, a couple more comments. Of course, Shane Proctor said, Kawasaki, you ain't got to work on them. You just race them. CJ400RG, he said, Tommy Maselli on Brad Mummer's GS ran away from Kent Stott's Turbo in Houston in 99.
Well, that was 99, CJ. You know better. It is, CJ, and you know what time it is, CJ.
Uh-oh. All right, y'all.
It's good to see CJ in here. You know, yeah, I ain't seen Chris in a minute, man. That's cool. Ricky, we've got some people in here tonight.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, I wasn't trying to stir nothing. I just said, well, that's what we're going to talk about. And everybody assumed y'all was going to be on. So thank y'all. Y'all make us look like rock stars. Ricky, we'll get you on here for history one night. Yeah, I know you got plenty of stories.
Yeah, that's a good idea. No joke.
All right. Man, I told on the last podcast real quick, but I'll tell Ricky, we were at ATCO. I'm in the trailer somewhere. CJ's in there telling us a story. I hear my class call. I get up. He said, sit your ass down. I ain't done telling this story. I sat back down, Ricky. I almost missed the fucking class because CJ400 says, sit down. He was telling stories about you too. And I sat down. So I was like, all right, I almost missed the damn class because of CJ. So
CJ, man, we got stories. We need to get CJ on here. That'd be a good idea.
If we get CJ and Ricky on here, oh my
CJ CJ remembers everything.
I don't know how.
Listen, he's been out there in the streets with me from way back when I started, me and Shine, and he can tell you every race me and Shine and Chris Williams ever had.
And Ron Arnold, he just chimed in. He reminded me what it was. He said it was a swimming pool story because Ron was with me. Yeah. I remember that for sure. Ricky knows.
I remember we had a race. We used to race in the pool. We at ATCO. I think it rained at ATCO, and everybody went to my house, and we got in the pool. And I said nobody could be. CJ said nobody could beat him. I said shit. This is my pool. CJ got that.
I love Chris. I give him some shit sometimes. I get talking shit to him. He gets mad at me, but I've always been a fan.
Oh man. All right, we'll let you two Real Street legends go. Get ready for your race, big race. Appreciate y'all joining us.
Yeah, Ricky's going to put a coat of wax on his, and Spitzer's going to go build his motor.
You know it.
I got some.
You know sure.
Real clean.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, copy in that fast bike colors don't make you fast.
Oh, wow. All right.
You'll learn. You'll learn.
That's right. Looking forward to it, fellas. Thanks for joining us. I'm going to let y'all go. We're going to give away a $600, $700 gift here in a second. So appreciate y'all jump in.
Hell yeah. See ya.
Right, see y'all.
All right. Wow.
I hope y'all enjoyed that. That worked out really well.
We went from potentially disastrous, thinking y'all were tricking it, or we were tricking y'all, which we never were trying to, but man, that's cool. Appreciate Ricky jumping on like literally last minute. Spencer, when we called him beforehand, he's like, is RG going to be on? I'm like, I don't, he's like, I got his number. I was like, well, text him, so wake him up.
Yeah.
tell him, jump on.
Man, Ricky's always been cool about getting on lives and stuff that need to happen though.
Yeah, for sure. All right. So we're going to giveaways. Let's see here. Let me pull up my spreadsheet. Have I figured out how to share on this thing, Dustin?
Yeah, I thought we did it last time, didn't we?
Present, share screen, select window, entire screen. Can y'all see it? Uh-oh.
There it is.
There we are. All right. So these are all our awesome patrons, podcast subscribers.
No, it's showing us.
What? What? It's not showing you or sharing your entire screen. It's not showing the wheel.
No, it's showing the next window over. You need to click the wheel. You need to click the wheel tab.
I am on it.
No, you're on the stream. You're on the studio stream.
I don't know. It won't show it then. Let's see here. You're on your entire screen. Oh, I don't know what to do there. Oh, messed it up. All right. Maybe it's not going to work. All right. Now, how do I get out? See, this is technical difficulties. I feel like Spencer right now. Stop screen.
There it goes.
Let me try it one more time. Share screen, select window or screen. I want to select a different window. Entire screen. I don't think it's going to work. You can see the tab though, right?
I mean, I could before it pulled up and it just showed this screen, like what we see right now.
But you can't see that wheel on the screen.
No, right now it shows the StreamYard studio deal playing, but it's froze, like we're froze up.
All right. Well, Dustin will be...
Per usual, know. I'll vouch for it.
Yeah, he'll vouch.
But you could... let's see. You could show this with your camera. You could turn your camera around.
Wow, now we're getting real fancy. All right, I stopped it. We're back to normal, right?
Yeah.
Let me see.
You could just do it on your laptop and turn your camera around that's recording your face, and they could see it. Easy.
My camera is on the laptop.
Ah,
it's built in.
I don't have that problem.
All right, look, y'all can trust us. Y'all are subscribers. We ain't screwing nobody. I'm just spinning the damn wheel, all right? Look, I'm clicking it right now. Enough of this shit. All right, it's spinning. I'm telling y'all, it's spinning. Whoever wins gets to pick between the carbon fiber tank shell. I think Mike said he can do a regular one, right, too, instead of his, like, heavy hitters one. Is that correct?
I'm sure he would do whatever you want.
And then, or you can get a frame short neck service. Hopefully, it's somebody with a name on here. Oh, my goodness. Uh-oh.
And I can't see the email. Look it up. See if it's in my file.
Oh, my goodness. Who is it? Dylan Klevenstein. This man is on fire.
Yeah.
Not only is he in the university.
Yeah.
Not only is he a school member who's just been wearing people out, went to 6 straight finals. Crystal, you were close. I see you got your fingers crossed. You were – no, sorry. It was somebody else. You were, I thought I seen your name. It was closer to you. Anyhow, Dylan, you won, man. You get your choice. Yeah, Dylan's school member and a subscriber to the podcast. So that's awesome. Congratulations, Dylan. I'll get with you on that. There's still more stuff though. Okay. So that whatever Dylan decides, he's going to pick one of those two, right? Next giveaway or next big giveaway, you get the last big prize, but we still got a Penske Shock.
That's a big one right there.
That's still to be given away at the end of the year. We got it. We're going to do a few little extra things on that with the Shock. Basically, probably going to do like what we say, like some $5 raffle tickets that if you haven't been a subscriber, maybe.
Yeah, like if people hasn't subbed up and they want to, you know, get in on the game, we can do some like little stuff with the Shock one and all that stuff.
Yeah. And our man Dustin at Penske, he said, I'm waiting on this Shock giveaway. He's ready to build y'all a badass Penske Shock. All right. excuse me. I got a lot of work to do. I'm behind. So I'm getting off here. Dustin's got bikes to work on or rest his pretty little heart.
The bikes are done, bro.
Rest your heart.
He's got load junk.
There you go. All right. Appreciate
it. I hope y'all enjoyed the live. It come out pretty good. And if you have suggestions on stuff for us to talk about,
send them.
Can let us know. If not, it's our show.
All right. Thank you all for joining in. Hopefully y'all enjoyed it. That was wild. We had fun. Yep. So yeah. All right. Peace out, y'all. See you.
Bye now.